Arlo's blaming himself big time for what happened. But you know, you can't stop everything all the time. Hi!
Toadie's worried that people will run him out of town for what he did. If people do that, I don't blame them, but I don't think they will.
What exactly? What? Another legend came true?
Thank you. Thank you.
Won't be necessary. It's no surprise Huss and Tuss were behind all this, but when Remington and I arrived, they were here, tied up and ready to be taken away. All that was missing was a little pink bow. They said they were attacked by a masked man with a sword who was incredibly skilled. Remington has already sent them back to the Civil Corps. The only thing resembling a clue we found at the scene was a spatula.
A spatula?
My spatula, how did you get it?
It was left at the graveyard with the defeated bandits. Are you the man in the mask?
You know, some mysteries are better left unsolved.
You've been solving all the problems around town. You're a hero.
A hero? Nah. I was simply feeling a bit nostalgic for my old days as a knight. In any case, I think it'd be best we kept this between you and me. Heroes attract villains.
I won't tell anyone if you don't want me to.
Thanks a bunch.
Say, Django. Whatever happened to the Shining Apple?
Shining Apple? A little old to be believing fairy tales now, aren't we? I found a power stone in an apple after beating that foul pig-nosed owl the other day. Perhaps that was your Shining Apple.
I see.
It's too bad about what Toadie did, but I admire him for at least standing up for what he believed in. Right or wrong, we all have the right to that.
I buy fish from Toadie once in a while. I can't believe he would do something like that.
Hey! Here they go again! They ran off. Thanks for your help. Sorry to bother you again. In return, here are some...
Amazing! I still need to fine-tune the AI, but we did it! With this, I might even be able to make it to the front page of Vegafy's annual documented!
Amazing!
No!
Something terrible has happened, and it's all my fault!
Wait, what happened?
The robot! It's going berserk! It was working properly last night, but when I turned it on this morning for a field test, it went crazy! Right now it's running wild in town and no one can stop it!
Director, there you are. Trying to run away from your mistakes, are you? I told you that horrible thing was dangerous. And now look at the mess. Everyone in town is terrified.
I don't understand. It should have worked perfectly. Please, will you help me stop it? Thank you, thank you! I understand you might have to break it, but maybe try to be careful. If the pieces are intact, I could figure out what went wrong.
I'll try.
Crazy. Both...
Hello? Call me a donut, but I'm getting really popular around here. There are even tourists coming to Portia just to taste my cooking. How about that?
But I do miss my dear Lara.
What happened to her?
Fry my circuits! I'm not sure. There must be something wrong with my memory chips. Oh no.
Do you remember her looks? Maybe you can give me a drawing and I can make a replica model of Lara for you.
Holy lemonade! That's a great idea. Hang on. This is...
That's... I'll see what I can do.
Make sure you get her legs just right. I'm kind of picky.
Hey!
Thank you so much for stopping that robot. I'm certainly going to have a chat with Merlin about bringing in relics of this size in the future.
You have what we need? Let me have it!
It says, to the most beautiful and the most charming lady, Madame Aurora. Greetings and best wishes to you and your endless elegance. This is the newest product from the Xander Company, the Uplifter. You could adjust your face features easily and freely by the tap of your fingers. I sincerely wish you a happy 25th birthday and hope you enjoy our gift. End preface. Please enter the password.
This must have been a birthday gift. Whatever this uplifter is, it must still be in good quality inside the safe box.
Wasn't Madame Aurora supposedly the most beautiful woman back in the old world? I read about her in The Last Dawn, and it says people who pursued her could line up from here to another planet. I wonder what the password is.
That makes sense. Since this is a birthday gift, then the password must be related to her. Petra, are there any lines in that book mentioning the lady's birthday?
Yes, there was a whole section about how magnificent her coming-of-age ceremony was. I think it was the 15th of summer. Supposedly, 10,000 people showed up for the party. I always thought the author was just making it up. What a strange-looking relic.
We should be grateful that we found something like this. It's not often we have the privilege to see an undamaged machine from the old world.
From the description earlier, maybe it's a machine that can change a person's face.
I'll show this to Dr. Xu and see what he thinks. If there's a use for it, I'll let you know.
Just the person I'm looking for.
What can I do for you, Arlo?
Well, I was going through my usual training regimen last night, and as I was completing my 500th punch, my training dummy broke. I need a replacement as soon as possible. I'm counting on your skills to craft me a training dummy that won't. Think you're up to the challenge? Excellent! I'm eager to return to my usual routine. I think the diagram for the training dummy is for exchange at the research center.
Thank you.
Why would they do that?
Thank you.
All done? Great! Now we just wait for A and G to do their magic. Great work!